So you have to remember this particular image well, always, right? You can see this. This will tell you the entire fourth unit can be recognized from this one image. You can see that you have the neural tube, the notochord, the paraxial mesoderm, and the lateral pes mesoderm. And each of this is going to develop into the splanchnic mesoderm that develops in the heart and the blood, somatic mesoderm that gives the body cavity, pelvis, and the limbs and the extraembryonic structures, and the paraxial mesoderm, then the cauda mesoderm that gives the notochord, and the intermediate mesoderm that gives you the kidney and the gonads. So we have seen kidney, gonads, we have studied. Even the gastric structures we have studied. Only thing that remains is the stomates and the derivatives. So look at this as the clearly you can see the three different structures. So this is your neural tube, right? So it is going to give you a notochord, then the sclerotome and the dermatome. So the somate, if you look at the apical portion, it is going to be the dermatome, whereas the bottom layer is going to be the sclerotome. So dermatome and the sclerotome is what we are going to see how they are going to get formed. You can see how the derivatives, right? These are all individual cells now. So these derivatives, you can see the derivatives are going to develop the tendons here. They are going to develop the distal ribs here. It is going to give the skeletal muscles here. So all these structures, actually, the somites. I would like to people to mute your mics if there is a noise in your background, right? So I would like to mute your mics. Okay, so now we'll move how this particular structures are getting formed. So, okay, the sclerotome development. So, it is exactly the sclerotome, you know where it is. It is exactly at the lower region of your paraxial mesoderm. So, this ventromedial portion of the somite, that is the somites exactly, and from the middle of the somite to the bottom. This particular portion of the somites will go into a transition called epithelial to mesenchymal transition. So this we have already seen the other version, right? Mesenchymal to epithelial transition, we have seen it in the kidneys, right? Anantu, you can play your music off. Anantu, please switch off your music. I just want the mics to be open, because in between, if you have any doubts, you can stop and ask me. Not to play your music, Anantha.
Sorry, sir. It's all sorry.
It's okay. So, this epithelial to mesenchymal transition happens, right? So, it signals the formation of the sclerotome from the somite. So, in the somebody can tell me where this transition from the reverse of this mesenchymal to epithelial is happening in kidney development? Anyone of you can tell me? Anyone? Anyone can tell me the reverse of this epithelial to mesenchymal to epithelial transition? No one? Okay. So this epithelial to mesenchymal transition signals the formation of the skeletal. Okay. So this epithelial to mesenchymal transition create the midline and the axial structures as well as the vertebral column. So the genes that involves are the PAX1 transcription factor, okay, and the cartilage and the other structures. So epithelial cells, what happens is how they convert into mesenchymal cells. We know that epithelial cells are columnar structures, so they form individual columns, but they lose the encadrein that binds the cells, and they become loose and they form the mesenchymal cells. So the mesenchymal cells of the skeleton give rise to the precursors of the vertebrae and the rib cartilage, dorsal syndeto, that is your tendons, and meninges of the spinal cord is give rise from the skeleton, and the central arthrotomes. So you have four different cells, the structures that are formed from the mesenchymal cells that are differentiated from your ventromedial portion of the somite. So ventromedial portion of the somite actually transform itself to the mesenchymal cells, and they create the skeleton by expression of specific transcription factors and loosing of the encadrein of the epithelial cells make the cells become mesenchymal, and these mesenchymal cells give rise to vertebrae and rib, dorsal syndetome, meninges and the central arthrotome. Okay, this is the skeleton. So this is this image, as usual, it is taken from the Gilbert's book, shows you the different structures, actual electron scanning microscope of the formation of skeletome from your chick embryo. You can see the notochord here, you can see the somites. So this part, right, the ventromedial part is going to get converted into skeleton. So the above part is going to become the dermatome and the myotome that we'll see later. So this part, you can see, they will give rise to the different structures, like this is your iota, right? So you have the next to the neural tubes, you form the notochord structures, the hinges. All the structures are getting formed from the thing. This is the actual picture, the scanning electron microscope image that you can see in the book, the textbook that we have prescribed, the Gilbert one. Okay. Again, in this also you can see that here. You can see the entire somite is actually differentiated, and this portion is going to be the skeletome. Skeletome, this portion is going to be the skeletome, whereas this portion is going to be the myotome. They call it as dermomyotome. Okay, and there are abaxial somatic cells that is far away from that, and the paraxial one that is closer to the neural tube, as well as you have the dermal regions. So what happens to a somite, right? So you can see that there are several somites. Each somite, depending upon the location it is getting formed in the embryo, they are going to develop into structures that will form a particular portion of your body. Okay, so you have the ventromedial portion. Okay, so these somites are close to the notochord. So this particular those cells that are going to be closer to the notochord is going to become the skeletomes. Okay, so the important protein that is involved in the induction of this skeletome is the SHH. This you have already seen the sonic hedgehog protein. In turn, it induces the SOX 5-6 transcript factors, that in turn induces the SOX9 transcription factor. What happens is this particular induction of this SOX9, actually what it does is it is an agonist for the BMP. So BMP, you have seen already, they give rise to the muscular structures. Okay, so if the BMP is expressed, then there is no formation of the cartilage. So what happens is the noggin and the germline, two BMP agonists, are induced by the SOX9 protein, and this protein actually inhibit the BMP. So in turn, it induces the Sony Hedgehog expression induces the cartilage differentiation. Okay, so what happens is once this notochord, and it will become mesenchymal cells, and it form the epimorphine and the cartilage. So this is the formation of vertebrae. Okay. So if you look at the resegmentation or splitting of the sclerotome, so you can see that there are two things: the rostral or the anterior part and the caudal part. Okay. So the anterior part combines with the posterior part. Okay. Next to the anterior sclerotome to form the vertebrae rudiment, that you can see that clearly in the next image here. You can see that this image, if you remember, this is going to help you in understanding the structures. You can see this is your neural tube. So this is what we have studied first, right? The formation of the neural tube and the neural structures. So if you look at it, neural tube, this is your somite, this is your lateral plate mesoderm. So you can see, even in the sclerotome, you have two portions. If you cut the somites into half, the ventromedial, right, ventromedial region is going to develop into a portion called a sclerotome. What happened to the upper portion of the dermatome? It is the dermatome, that is the muscles that forms the skin, and the proliferating myoblasts. In the other parts of the body also, we require some of the muscles. So that is what we call, that is for that we require this proliferating myoblasts and two types of muscles. Okay, abaxial muscles and the primaxial muscles. So the primaxial muscles are closer to the neural tube. You remember that abaxis muscles are away from your neural tube. So if you look at this, they are going to develop into the limbs and the body wall and the other part. So you have one single somite can give rise to 3-4 different kind of tissues in the body. One is the bottom portion, that is the sclerotome, that is going to give rise to your notochord, your tendons, your cartilage and the vertebrae. Okay, so the upper part will be divided into four groups. One is abaxial and primaxial muscles that is going to be developed from the myoblast, and the dermatome that is going to develop into dermis, and the proliferating myoblast that is going to develop into the muscle cells. Okay, you can also see the factors that is involved. Okay, so we have seen that wherever there is a BMP, there is no formation of sclerotome. Okay, you can see the dark red region, which where the BMP is getting expressed. If BMP is getting expressed, this noggin. Okay, so BMP, there is no sclerotome differentiation. If you look at the wherever this noggin is present, we have studied that noggin is a agonist for the antagonist for the BMP. So wherever there is a noggin, there is no BMP expression. So this lower part, entire lower part that is destined to become the sclerotome, is devoid of the BMP expression because of the noggin that is expressed from the notochord. Okay, So, and also you can see that the wind 1, wind 3 path signaling factors that is going to induce the myoblast formation. Those cells that are destined to become muscles will express the MYF5 protein and the PAX protein, MyoD protein. All these proteins are important for development of muscular structures. So the muscular structures are the, you can say that the upper half portion of the somite is going to develop into the muscular structures, whereas the bottom portion is going to develop into the other structures like tendons, vertebrae, and the cartilage. Okay, remember this particular image, it will be easier for you to write it in your exams. Further, you can see that here you can see, so it is the other cross sections, the transverse section. So you can see that the three different important regions, the sclerotome, okay, your dermatomyotome that is going to be forming the back of your skin, and the neural tube that is here. So later, as the development happens, you can see that your entire back of the skin is going to be like this. The vertebra is getting formed, and each vertebra will be developing a neuron, important neuron, through the somite. You can see that. Okay, and this, they will connect to specific muscles. Okay, so you can see that each somite will have its own neuronal structures, nerve structures, that will connect to the different parts of the muscles and give rise to the sensory organs. So what happened to the notochord? So the notochord, what happens is they undergo apoptosis. So if you look at the adults, the notochord initially, if you remember the gastrulation process, it is a notochord that is going to initiate the gastrulation process. But if you look at the adult, as the animal, as the organism develops, the notochord will be slowly deteriorating and it will undergo apoptosis. So you can see that the signaling is this notochord, Sony HK, the axis get elongated. Initially, then this notochord cells undergo apoptosis and they form the notochord sheath alone. You don't see a proper notochord in the adults. So the first structure is the notochord. Then the other structure is the syndetome. So syndetomes are nothing but the tendons. Probably you know what are tendons. The tendons are the muscle fibers that connect the muscles that is going to be involved in pushing and pulling, the leveraging of your muscles. Okay, so you can see that the formation of the tendons are controlled by the scleraxis gene. Okay, so what happens is very closer to the myotome, and SOX5 genes, it actually prevents the FGF factor. So FGF factor 8 is getting restricted. Restriction of the FGF factor, actually what happens is it creates the tendons. So far, if you have anything to know, you can just ask me. And the percentage is only 40 people are there. What happened to the rest of you? Did you inform your friends that the meeting is going on? Hmm? Hello. Deviti. Deviti, Divya, what happened to the rest of you? Any idea? Chandrika?
Yes, sir.
So what happened? Only 40 people are there. Why? There is very low attendance.
I don't know, sir.
So I just, is there any difficulty in joining that class or something like that? That's what I want to check. Okay. Okay, ma. I'll start continuing this.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So actually, we have seen this, right, already. The derbato, that is the upper portion of your somite, and the sclerotome, that is the ventral most portion of your somite. Now, if we look at it, okay, there is a greenish layer developed later. Okay, this particular layer is called as syndetome. The syndetome is immediately above your sclerotome. That is going to give rise to your tendons. So sclerotome, syndetome, myotome, and dermatome. So always remember, dermatome, dermis, skin, sclerotome for your cartilage, syndetome for your tendons, and myotome for your muscles. Okay. So the wherever there is a expression of FGF, fibroblast growth factor, you can see it is actually developed into inhibition of this FGF will lead to the tendon. So sclerotome and the sclerotome will give rise to both cartilage as well as the tendon. But where differentiate is the Sonic Hedgehog protein, right? That is going to be secreted from the notochord and the notochord floor plate is the differentiator here. What it does is this Sonic Hedgehog will initiate the expression of SOX and SOX5, SOX6 and the cartilage. Whereas in the absence of the Sonic Hedgehog, you know that, no, it is very closer to this, right? The, if you look at that, the sclerotome is closer to the notochord. So this region of your somite is going to be developing into the cartilage. Whereas the other region, just the region above your sclerotome, this particular greenish region, it is not receiving the SHH. So what happens? There are other transcription factors like P3 and ERM transcription factor. They induce a protein called sclerosix, and that is going to be the cause for the tendon formation. So both cartilage as well as the tendon is created from the sclerotome, but the Sonic Hedgehog is the culprit here. That wherever there is a Sonic Hedgehog expression, it is going to be the pathway like SOX6 and SOX5-6 cartilage. If there is no Sonic Hedgehog, they'll inhibit the PA and transcription factors that will going to develop into the tendons. Okay. So the second part is the dermatome. We have seen the formation of the cartilage, formation of the tendons. So what happens to the uppermost portion, the dermatome here? So the dermatome is the dorsolateral half of the somite that I have told you already, right? So here there is no transformation of your epithelial to mesenchymal change. So we have seen that in the sclerotome, we have seen it lose the enchadrin and it is going to develop into the mesenchymal cells. But here the epithelial structures are maintained, no loss of enchadrin. So what happens? This particular dermatome will be forming dermatome, that is the back of the dermis, and the myoderm and the migratory myoblast. So the dermomyoderm will give rise to the migratory myoblast. So if you remember, if this is your somite, you can divide it into two portions. This part is going to be the dermomyoderm, DM. This part is going to be the sclerotome. Sclerotome, if the one that is closer to the notochord will be developing into, can anyone tell what it will develop into? Hello? Can anyone tell me what this portion of the somite, right? This is your neural tube. Imagine this, the gas law is going to be like this, right? So what this part will develop into? This part will be developing into a sclerotome and the syndetome. Okay, so what happens? So the formation of myotome is like, it will form the dorsomedial lips and the ventrolateral lips. They fuse together to form the myotome. So myoblasts are from the primaxial muscles that are closer to the neural tube, and the abaxial muscles we have discussed, that is far away from the neural tube, they'll give rise to body limbs and the tongue, whereas the primaxial muscle will give rise to the intercostal muscles. This also we have discussed earlier. So finally, the central dermis of the myoderm is divided by the WNT6 pathway. This also we have studied. So those genes that are involved, you can study that. We have explained it already. If you look at the two myotomes, the primaxial myotome and the abaxial myotome, how they are going to develop into structures. So you can see that this is your primaxial, this is your abaxial. Closer to the neural tube is the primaxial. Away from your neural tube is going to be your abaxial. So you can see that here, you can see the expression of the PAX3. MIFI3 and myogenin, that is going to give rise to the myoblast. Whereas here, the ectoderm, so it can receive the signals from the ectoderm, not from the neural tube. So they'll produce this WNT expression. So WNT nagin, we know that hypoaxial lip, this will induce the formation of the myogenin. So if there is a BMP, you can see the expression of the myogenin here. So next thing, what I'm going to do is, I'll play you one video that is going to help you in understanding the somite pattern. You can finish up with this video actually.
Picture on the right hand side shows a 31-day-old embryo. In the lateral view in green, we can see the head and the 6 branchial arches, and then along the dorsum we see in yellow these segments of somites, and there is the cervical somites and thoracic and lumbar somites as well as sacral somites, and then we have at the tail end some of these coccygeal and then more cranially pre and post otic somites that we're not going to really consider all together in yellow and purple. 40 to 42 somites in humans. We're going to focus on the somites highlighted in those dotted lines. So the 8 cervical, 12 thoracic, 5 lumbar, and 5 sacral somites. We're going to take one of those segments, take a cross section through it, and ta-da! There we have this cross section through a somite and one somite highlighted in yellow. And in this picture, there's the neural tube will become the spinal cord. Neural crest cells become the dorsal root ganglion. And simply for orientation, there's the gut tube with the associated somatic cavity and all on the other side. Shing, there we've got the somite. So let's talk about the dermatome, myotome, and sclerotome.
So you can see there the somite will give rise to dermatome, myotome. The myotome can be epimere and hypermere on the sclerotome.
Chromal components, those three elements that comprise these condensations of periaxial mesoderm that we know as the somites. So first in pink, we have the dermatome. These dermatomal cells are more superficial in this somite, and they're going to migrate out and become the dermis of the skin of the back. The overlying ectoderm is derived, it becomes the epithelium. The dermatome becomes the skin of the back. And as you go forward more and you get this ring, as you can see in this picture in pink, the body wall and the skin of the limbs comes really from the somatic part of the lateral plate mesoderm, but it's from the same segment, so the principle's the same. And there we have in pink this ring of skin. And in yellow, there is our spinal nerves. And so the dorsal root, the dorsal ramus primarily sends off branches, provides sensory innervation of this, the dermis of the dorsum of the back. And then this ventral ramus courses and gives rise to a lateral branch that provides sensory innervation of the lateral part of this band of dermis. And then it terminates as an anterior cutaneous branch, which then sends sensory information from the front. And therefore, when we see this entire band in pink, it's innervated by all the branches bilaterally of dorsal and ventral rami, and it forms this ring of innervation of the skin. Hence the clinical definition of a dermatome, an area of skin supplied by a single spinal nerve level. The segmental happens 8 times in cervical, 12 thoracic, and so forth. Myotome is the region highlighted in purple and red because the myotome has two parts. The epimere, which are these cells that migrate more dorsally to the
epimere.
Epi for a pond, the top part of this developing embryo. And these cells are going to develop into the erector spinae muscles. Whereas the hypomere in red, these cells migrate more ventral laterally and they form the body wall muscles, hypo below on the bottom of this developing embryo. But in the cervical and lumbosacral regions become axial muscles, which is 4 layers of lateral body wall, a subvertebral group of components. These are segmentally from top to bottom, and so they protect the spinal cord, but there's spaces in between for the spinal nerves to exit at each segmental level and also allows for some flexibility. So here we have that picture now.
So you have this dermatome that forms the epiderm and the two important epaxial and hypaxial myotomes that is going to give rise to your muscle structures. And the sclerotome that is going to give rise to your neural tube, the cartilages and the tendons that are formed from the epaxial sclerotome muscles. So these three are the important derivatives of the somites.
Epaxial, hypaxial muscles, and the sclerotomal component. Looking at this lateral view yet again, and we take one segment and shing, we blow that up, and there we have a segment. All those components, vertebral, spinal cord, spinal nerve levels with dermatomes, myotomes. But how about this level? Same thing at that level. There is a vertebral level, spinal cord level, associated spinal nerve with dermatome and myotome. Oh, but what about this level? And the same thing. The key to this is to recognize that every single segmental level of 8 cervical, 12 thoracic, 5 lumbar, 5 sacral levels, there is going to be a vertebral element.
There's
going to be a spinal cord element. There's going to be a spinal nerve element with a dermatome and myotome. Those three themes we're going to see over and over again now as we look at the neurological levels of each of these regions.
So probably this slide might have helped you in understanding how this particular somites are going to be developing into different structures. So,
hi, it's Mr. Anderson, and in this video, I'm going to talk.
Okay. So, is there any questions that is there? Can discuss. Hello. Hello, everyone. Excuse me. Is there anyone? So, if there is no questions, then we can stop the session. Thank you very much for your listening.